Hey, how's it going, everybody? It's your bro. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys about switches in Java. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. You can become a hero and save our channel by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro. Okay, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. In this video, I'm going to explain how switches work. A switch is a statement that allows a variable or other value to be tested for equality against a list of values. So if you find yourself in a situation where you're using a lot of if statements back to back, it's probably more efficient to use a switch statement instead. Here are the different data types that we can use to test for equality within a switch. And according to this description, one thing that we can check is the equality of a string. For this program, let's test to see if a string, let's say it's going to be a day of the week, is equal to a list of days of the week. If there's a match, we can display a custom message. So let's say string day equals maybe Friday, because I like Friday, and we will create a switch to see if our day equals a certain day. So this is how to create a switch. Type in the word switch, a set of parentheses, then a set of curly braces. Within the parentheses, we're going to list the value or the variable we would like to test for equality against a listing of cases. So our first case will be Sunday. This is what we're comparing our value or variable to. We're going to compare this variable to our case. So type in the word case followed by the value, colon, and if there is a match, what would you like to do? So I would like to perform a print line statement that states, it is Sunday. And then this next part is important. It's important to add the keyword break, so we break out of the switch and continue on with the rest of our code. So let's create another case for Monday. So I'm going to copy and paste, change Sunday to Monday, and I will print, it is Monday. So I'm going to repeat this process a few times. And it's done. So I have a case for each day of the week, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and I have a corresponding print line statement for each day of the week, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, so on and so forth. So with our string of day, we're going to place this within the switch statement to compare for equality against a list of values. One by one, our switch is going to evaluate our day against each case. If there is a match, it's going to perform this subset of code. If there is no match, it's going to continue down to the next case and check to see if these values are equal. So let's test it. Currently our day is set to Friday, so this should display it is Friday. All right, so let's change this to Monday next. And this will display it is Monday. All right, this is why it's important to have these breaks after each case. So I'm going to remove this for this demonstration and show you why these are important. So if we were to run this again, this time we do not have those breaks. As soon as there is a matching case, we will perform this subset of code as well as each subset of code that comes after our matching case. So that's why it's important to have these breaks within, well, after each case within our switch. So what if there is no match? Let's say our day is equal to pizza, which is not a day, but honestly, it really should be. Well, it will basically just do nothing. So one thing that we could do is add a default. Default, colon, if there is no match, what do we want to do? System.out.println, that is not a day. So let's try this again. If there is no match within our switch, we will perform whatever is set within the default case, which displays pizza is not a day. So that's all what a switch is. It allows a variable or other value to be tested for equality against a list of values. If you find yourself in a situation where you're using a lot of if statements, it might be better to use a switch instead. So that's all about switches. If you would like a copy of this code, I will post this in the comments down below. Please be sure to smash that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.